One property of a soil that we can't really see is its pH, or how acid or alkaline it is. Now, even though we can't see that property, some of our plants will soon tell us if the pH around their roots is wrong. Let's have a look at this poor hydrangea down here. Its yellowing young leaves indicates that it's not getting enough iron from the soil down there around its roots. The pH is wrong for it down there. How can we help it? The first thing to do is to check the pH of some of the soil from around the roots of the plant. I'm going to use this simple test kit here. It's cheap and readily available in most garden centres. The first thing to do is to put some of the soil onto this test plate and then add to it some of this liquid here, which changes its colour as pH changes. Just a little bit there, that's all we need. Mix them round together. You can't see much colour there, so what we have to do now is put some of this white powder onto the slurry there. You can see the colour coming up there now. Wow, look at that. It's really purple. And that matches up with pH 9.5 on the scale here. And that's really alarming. That's very bad for that plant. No wonder our poor old hydrangea is yellow. Perhaps I'd better explain about pH. A pH of 7 indicates neutrality. Numbers lower than 7, say 4, 5 or 6, indicate that the soil is acid. Somewhat like vinegar or battery acid. A number above 7 indicates that the soil is alkaline, and this soil here is very alkaline indeed. And the thing about these numbers is that, say, in going from 8 to 9 indicates that at 9 there's 10 times the amount of alkalinity in the soil as there is at 8. So how can we help this poor plant? Well, we could spray it with an iron chelate solution, and that would green it up for a while, but only for a while. That's only a temporary solution. If the pH of the soil down here were no more than 8, we could sprinkle sulfur around down here, and that would eventually react with the alkalinity and reduce the pH to perhaps 7. But because the pH down here is so high, it's around 9.5, it's better that we just rip this plant out and put another one in its place, one that can cope with that high alkalinity. pH is also very important to plants in pots. The ideal range for potting mixes is from about 5 to about 6.5. Most of the plants around me here are looking pretty healthy, and I would expect that if I tested the pH of the mixes in those pots, that it would be somewhere in that range. But there's one here that I found down the back that's looking rather ill. If we can compare its quality with its sister here, just the same species, we can see just how bad it is. I'm going to check the pH of the mix in this pot. This time I'm going to use a pH meter rather than the test kit that we used on the soil. The way to check pH is, first of all, to just tip the plant out like that, and then to take a slice of potting mix like that. Just take it right down through there, and then put that back over here, and then mix that together a little bit, and then take a sample, just a small sample like that. Now, this time I'm using a pH meter rather than the kit that we used before. We get the same result, but I'll just show you using this one. So one volume of the mix, and then we have 1.5 volumes of water. Now, this should be deionized water or tank water, so it's about 1.5 volumes. Tip that in there, just mix it around and make it sort of a slurry. You should leave that sit for about 5 minutes before you check the pH, or we'll do it straight away now. See there, yes, the pH is below 5, and that really is too low for this sort of plant. All we can do with a plant like this is to remove as much of the old acid potting mix as possible and then to repot it. That's all easy enough for a small plant in a small pot. What about a huge plant in a big tub? All you can really do there is sprinkle a mixture of lime and dolomite, about 1 to 1, on the surface of the mix in the pot. Water it in, and it will gradually go down and react with the acidity in the pot. You may have to do that several times, but just check the pH every couple of weeks until it's right. You can avoid all these problems by checking the pH of the mix in your pots about every 6 months.